morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
I'm not sure why, but the many hours and miles old Cody and I have spent in this year's fall gather seemed more enjoyable than ever. I guess maybe the relief from the scorching heat, the crisp fall air instead of smoke-filled skies, and it seems like just another season of cowboy heaven. Things aren't perfect, though, not by a long shot, and we do wonder about the coming year. And today, Larry Ramstead, longtime manager of the famous gang ranch, is back with more insight into the world of the West that we both love.
A lot of ranges have been turned back and are vacant. Some of them I don't know if they'll ever be filled with family ranches, and that the young people probably won't ever go back.
And we'll sneak a look into another cattle expert's crystal ball on the Rangeland News,
where we increased our steer price forecast by $2 per hundredweight.
And Baxter Black has a hilarious story about a trip to Louisiana he made with a couple of his brothers.
Brother number three turns to us with a beer in his hand and says, "I think I'm having a heart attack. I forgot my nitroglycerin."
And a very special one in the cowboy poetry spotlight from Randy Reeman.
"Circling of the sandhill cranes reminds us that it's time to be moving off a summer range and leaving camp behind."
On the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear, horse training file, an Arab quarter horse mare just won't settle down and relax after she gets into a full gallop when she's being ridden. And there are some things that might help. Larry Ramstead knew the great horseman Ray Hunt much better than most, and he'll share some insights about Ray that you might be surprised to hear after Bren Hill starts things off.
Frost on the wheat grass, frost on the sage, frost on the aspen leaves, steam on the lake. The blue autumn sky is turning colder by the day, and it's time to get this round of party underway. So buckle on your leggings, get your saddle cinched up tight for the roundup fire burns tonight. Cattle on the skyline, cattle in the trees, riders close behind them, and freedom on the breeze. Well, this way of life is getting older by the day, and it's time to get this round of party underway. So rousing up your ropes and spur your ponies quick and light for the round. I spent the summer waiting, working on the land, and I spend the winter waiting for the time to bring. And I spend a lifetime riding through the sage. It's burning in my blood, there is no other way. You can call me crazy, say whatever you, but it's time to get this round of party underway. So buckle on your leggings, get your saddle cinched up tight for the round of the fire burns tonight. Yeah, the round of the fire burns tonight.
Ramstead, longtime manager of the world-famous gang ranch, has a lot of good memories of the late Ray Hunt.
When did you first get to know Ray Hunt? I met Ray in San Antonio, I think it was the spring of 1980. I watched him do a demonstration and watched him, much like we watched here in Edmonton at these demos where a clinician will come in and spend, 3 hours and start a colt. And Ray was doing the same thing, and I'd never seen anything like that before. And now it's quite common to see these clinicians around. But Ray was the first one that I had ever seen. And it impressed me enough that I said that if I ever got a chance, I'd have him up sometime to do a clinic. And when we got to the gang, that was the opportunity. And after that, I think we probably had about 15, 16 clinics at the gang.
Yeah. I remember, I think Bev called me one time, and this was when Ray was still quite healthy and active and everything. And after the clinic, you were going to ride out and gather some cattle, and said, would you like to come up and ride with Larry and Ray Hunt and his gather? And I had something I couldn't get out of, and I've always thought, man, did I ever miss an opportunity there.
Yet Ray, he was pretty quiet for them, as well known as he was. He never did hardly ever do any interviews, I don't think. I know that he was approached several times. He'd phone and ring when he was at the house, and it'd be somebody wanting to talk to him or write an article or something, and I don't think I never did see him grant an interview or anything. He stayed pretty much to himself, but a great friend anyways. He was a good guy, really great.
Well, you would probably know him better than a lot of us.
Best times I had with Ray, I never was much on, I always liked the horses and was interested in what he was doing with them, but I never was interested in putting on clinics or anything like that. And a lot of the times that we spent together in between clinics or before and after or even in the evenings and mornings was just visiting about things that Ray had done previous to being a clinician, when he worked on as a buckaroo in Nevada and showed horses of his own and just tried to make a living by ranching. And he had some great stories, and it was, again, another good storyteller.
I'll bet you.
Yeah, it's just kind of a shame I never could get an interview with Ray, although I visited with him sometimes. But when I'd even suggest recording something, he would just say, oh, no, I'm not talking into no microphone. I'll tell you my stories, but not into that thing. Oh, they wouldn't have been great. Anyway, there's more from the Gang Ranch and Larry Ramstead when the Spirit of the West continues right after this.
Our mission is to help our clients sell their equipment in the most effective way possible. People who are looking at our auction, they are literally all over North America. Once we take somebody through a process from start to finish, the first time, they get it. You know, it's very simple. It's more simple than they think.
Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. The remuda at the world-famous Gang Ranch has improved a lot since Larry Ramstead took the reins, not just in the breeding and selection of the horses, but in the lengths he's gone to make sure that the cowboys have access to some of the finest horsemen around to really improve their horsemanship.
Did you ever run into Tom Dorrance or Bill Dorrance?
I never did, no. We were down at, there was a benefit for Tom, and he wasn't able to make it in Fort Worth there a few years back, and then passed away shortly after. Bev had talked to Tom several times on the phone. He'd call, and I didn't really know how they got together, but Bev, she had visited with him quite a bit.
It just seems to me that an awful lot of cowboys are safer and haven't had serious wrecks and haven't been bucked off and seriously hurt because of what those guys were able to teach us.
Yeah, for sure. They taught us so much. And I, again, another thing I thought about quite a lot, and it wasn't so much in maybe the way that we handled the stock or the horses as how we handled ourselves. And thinking back, that just about any time I got into a wreck or a problem or got hurt, it was because I was either mad or not thinking straight myself. But if you know, the way Ray and those fellas like that talked and it was more about a way of life than just the handling the horses again, anytime I've got into trouble, it's been my own fault.
Do you have any memorable wreck stories that
none special? No, I guess We've been hurt lots and had horses fall on us and you know, have been bucked off plenty of times but always seem to manage to avoid any big wrecks. And again, back to some of the men that I worked with, they worked so smooth that a wreck was the last thing that ever happened. I can't even remember, like, you hear a lot of people have been losing cattle, you know, dropping a herd or something like that. And I've never worked with some of the great guys and never ever happened.
You'll hear Larry's thoughts on the future of ranching in the West coming right up. And back at the Ivan Dane's Country Music Picnic last summer, I had a real nice visit with Danny Gibson. And I thought, boy, it's about time we played a song from Danny and his talented daughter, Susan.
I'm always wearing a cowboy hat. Without it, I just don't feel right. It's the first thing I put on every morning. It's the last thing I take off at night. When John B. invented the first Edson hat, I wonder if he could have guessed that with beaver hair and steam in his own hands, he created the greatest thing to top off the West. And I'm always wearing a cowboy hat. Without it, I just don't feel right. It's the first thing I put on every morning, it's the last thing I take off at night. The cowboy hat's a symbol of respect for your neighbor, your country and your maker, of course. And a big old hat is sure to make a cowboy look much better and as western as a saddle and a horse. And I'm always wearing a cowboy hat. Without it, I just don't feel right. It's the first thing I put on every morning. It's the last thing I take off at night. Across the Great Divide, I sometimes get to thinking about that. They're gonna have to bury me sitting up, 'cause we wouldn't wanna crumple up my hat. And I'm always wearing a cowboy hat. Without it, I just don't feel right. It's the first thing I put on every morning. It's the last thing I take off at night.
It's the last thing I'll be taking off tonight.
Great song. Danny wrote that one too. As well as the never-ending days in the saddle, the work in the shop and in the corrals and running a ranch means a lot of time spent in the office analyzing markets, expenses, and all the rest of that stuff. And Larry Ramstead talked about some of those things.
I'm hoping with the cattle numbers being the way they are in Western Canada and across the states that, if anything, the cattle prices may come up a little bit and maybe it'll compensate for some of the other high prices we're paying for diesel fuel and things like that that we have. That have come up while our prices were going down. So I think for those people that have managed to get through and have held their outfit together, the next 10 years looks pretty good.
That's good to hear. You know, we've noticed a big change in most of the big crown range permits around our place. Used to be even, we used to rent a lot of private grass for our cows, and you had to kind of get in line unless you got your word in the end of one season. There are two or three people with cattle looking for grass to rent. But boy, since about 2004 or 5 and the huge sell-off, there's all kinds of grass and just no cattle. Three or four of these big range permits haven't had cattle in them for 4 or 5 seasons, you know, and I guess that's probably going to change or turn around.
It probably will, it certainly will, I guess. Once it always happens, and cattle prices get good, people want to get back in. But in our area, too, up around the gang, east of us and north, there's a lot of open country. A lot of range has been turned back and are vacant. Some of them I don't know if they'll ever be filled. With family ranches and that, with the young people, probably won't ever go back.
You keep a lot of replacement heifers every year?
We'll breed about a little over 600. So we'll start kind of building the cow herd back if the weather stays right and our hay crops keep good. But about 600 would be an average.
And when will they start calving?
1st of March. We'll start on the 1st. We calve both the cows and the heifers at the same time just because of the way the ranch is situated, and have to get the cattle off that spring country as early as we can. So we don't split them up and calve one bunch earlier than the other. We just have to calve them at the same time. 1st of March, everything goes.
Well, we'll have more from Larry Ramstead in a little while, and coming up, you will hear what happened when Baxter Black took his brothers on a trip to Louisiana, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this.
Howdy, friends. This is Baxter Black on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan, and I'll be right back after this with Louisiana Paradise on the Half Shell.
Animal Health Express is your partner in animal health solutions, offering everything you need from livestock vaccines, vitamins and wormers, antibiotics and medications, to instruments and ear tags. They also have a large selection of tack and roping needs for the working cowboy. Independently owned and operated since 1990 by Tim and Barbara Jackson. Animal Health Express, for ranchers who mean business. 800-533-8115 or online at animalhealthexpress.com.
See Louisiana by starlight, ultralight, or flashlight. Paradise on the Half Shell. Two brothers and I toured the Kingdom of Acadiana, the home of Tabasco, Zydeco, and Overflow. Shellfish, lobsters, crabs, clams, oysters, crawfish, and armadillo claws abound on the menu. They are served in every imaginable fashion, all delicious, in huge portions and high in calories. They also rank at the top of the food chain in cholesterol. The good, you ask, or the bad? Friend, they're like horses and horse manure. You can't have one without the other. Brother number three was recovering from heart attack number one. He was not the first in our family, and after a childhood of wearing hand-me-downs, he was heard to comment in ICU, "I can't even have my own heart attack." On the last Saturday of our Bone Temps tour, we planned to start the morning at Fred's in Mamou. Live music begins at 9 a.m. The festivities are broadcast live on the radio, and for those of you who have become accustomed to catered events in modern hotel banquet rooms or designer homes with air conditioning, assorted vegetable trays with dip, and a wine bar, Fred's ambiance is a little earthier. Couples are dancing. Cajun music is loud. The beer is cold, and the place is packed, and you don't want to look at the floor. It's like being in a cave with the Chicago Bears. Everyone is big and happy. Brother number three turns to us with a beer in his hand and says, "I think I'm having a heart attack. I forgot my nitroglycerin." We lead him out into the morning sun. He was the color of catfish tongue. Brother four races back into the bar, finds the manager, who promptly steps to the microphone, stops the music, and asks from the bandstand, "We've got a visitor here having a heart attack. Anybody got any nitro?" 46 people over 200 pounds raised their hands in unison. They saved the day. Well, brother number three took their offering. Paramedics came and hauled him from Mamou Hospital to the one in Lafayette, where he received bypass number two. In reminiscing, he speaks lovingly of our trip as the See Louisiana by Ambulance Tour, Paradise on a Gurney. This is Baxter Black on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan. Thanks for listening.
If you're buying or selling farm machinery, heavy equipment, or trucks, let Progressive Auctions take the hassle out of your sale or your search. There's an online auction every Wednesday at progressiveauctions.ca. Doesn't matter where you live, Progressive Auctions can find the machinery or equipment you need, or the buyers who are looking for what you're selling. ProgressiveAuctions.ca. For more information, call 844-309-9424. Just ahead of the Rangeland news, if you've watched the Calgary Flames playing hockey, no doubt you've seen this guy singing the national anthem, and like most of the days, whatever the weather's doing, just about any day, I think, is a good day to ride George Canyon.
Every morning when I wake up, I pour coffee in my cup, and I look out on the fields and land that I call
if there's no chance of rain and I need to get away, I'll grab a saddle and be long, long gone. Looks like a good day to ride underneath this big warm sun. Looks like good day to ride. There's a world that's in a race for some money and some fame. Well, out here there's nothing. All I need is what I have. So when I want to free my mind from the concrete and the signs, I head for the mountains, back to who warm sun. Looks like a good day to let this old boy fly. Loose on the reins and on the run to a blue and endless sky. Looks like a good day to a good day to ride. Looks like a good day to ride. Yeah.
Not much can raise your stress level more than a tractor breakdown when you need it most. We've all spent hours on the phone and driving around trying to find the right parts, and that's no fun when you're missing something you need to finish the job. Here's a better way. Just go to bctractorparts.com. That's where you can find about any part for any make or tractor. If you're restoring a vintage tractor or just keeping up the maintenance on the ones you're using, you can have the parts you need in a short time. And you know what? There's some great pictures of tractor restoration projects and much more right there at bctractorparts.com. What? Oh, you don't have internet? Well, try calling Mark at 250-395-0960.
The Rangeland News from the Spirit of the West. A roundup of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
At the top of page one, it says, I've been lucky enough to spend a lot of days riding with good friends who graze about 600 nice black yearling steers in a beautiful piece of country. And as we've gathered them from the far corners of the ranch, it was obvious the weights would be down a little bit from the past years. And this is when the decisions are made about next year's plan. What to do, or what do we know so far? Well, we can't predict the amount of moisture or the grass growth, but Rod Bain is with a guy who is predicting what the prices might be.
Beef production forecasts have been lowered for this year and next. USDA World Agricultural Outlook Board Chair Mark Jekodowski explains why.
On the one hand, we're seeing higher cow slaughter, but on the other hand, we're seeing a reduction in steer and heifer slaughter and lower carcass weights. So those lower weights more than offset the increased cow slaughter.
However, steer prices are expected to rise both in 2021 and 2022.
We increased our steer price forecast for 2021 by $1 per hundredweight. Mainly what we're looking at here is just price activity to date, but also noting that there's been some strong demand supporting those prices. And we expect that to carry into 2022 where we increased our steer price forecast by $2 per hundredweight. So for 2022, we currently have a steer price forecast of $128.25 per hundredweight.
I'm Rod Bain reporting for the U.S. Department of Agriculture in Washington, D.C.
Well, the fall cattle markets are providing some insight into the effect the record heat, drought, and wildfires in the cattle country of the West have had. And here's one example. The Montana Beef Council collected checkoff dollars for the sale of 42,898 cattle in August 2020. In August 2021, they collected checkoff dollars for the sale of 104,396 head. That increase is 143%. A second case of anthrax has been reported in beef cattle in Kidder County, North Dakota this year. The case was confirmed by the North Dakota State University Veterinary Diagnostic Laboratory. The first case, also in Kidder County, was reported back in August. Effective anthrax vaccines are readily available, but it takes about a week for immunity to be established, and it must be administered annually for continued protection. And two cases of anthrax were reported in North Dakota in 2020. In 2005, though, more than 500 confirmed deaths from anthrax were reported. Those total losses amounted to more than 1,000 head of cattle. And, well, isn't this a bit of a head-scratcher? An article published on September 13th in the journal Current Biology says researchers have shown that cows can be potty trained, enabling waste to be collected and treated, thereby cleaning up the barn, reducing air pollution, and creating more open animal-friendly farms. It's usually assumed that cattle are not capable of controlling defecation or urination, says the co-author John Langbian. He's an animal psychologist at the Research Institute for Farm Animal Biology in Germany, but he says he and his team questioned this thinking. Cattle, like many other animals, especially farm animals, are quite clever, and they can learn a lot. Why shouldn't they be able to learn how to use a toilet? To body train the calves, a process they dubbed Moolu training, the research team with scientists from Germany and New Zealand worked backward. They started off by rewarding the calves when they urinated in the right place, in the latrine, and then they allowed the calves to approach the latrines from outside when they have to go. My goodness. Well, producers in British Columbia are being given a $20 million package by the provincial government after being hit by wildfires this summer for the third time in 5 years, according to the Ministry of Agriculture. It'll help pay for extraordinary expenses for everything from feed and shelter to transportation of livestock, along with animal health and safety. Producers are eligible for help under the 2021 Canada B.C. Wildfire and Drought Agri Recovery Initiative. And if you have questions about that, listen for Kathy McMillan's message coming up. Now, this funding includes replacing fencing or other critical infrastructure damaged or destroyed by the fires that was not insurable, along with the things such as reseeding forage. And BC Cattlemen's Association Chief Kevin Boone says he expects mortalities will probably be as high or higher than in 2017, and at that time, we lost close to a couple thousand head in the fires. He estimates that ranchers have lost up to 2,000 kilometers of fence, and that'll cost several million dollars to replace. And there is a line in a song from our Creek of the Leather CD that refers to a cattle drive from the Caribou Country to Ashcroft, B.C. around the turn of the century. And the line says, 8 cents a pound for the meat and 2 bits for the hide. Well, byproduct values for cattle have increased dramatically in the last few months, and hide and offal values, which have been generally declining, bottomed during the early stages of the pandemic in 2020 to the lowest levels since 2009. But in the past 13 months, steer hide and offal values have risen from $6.93 a hundredweight on a live-fed steer basis in July and August, to a value of $14.99, and that's an increase of 116%. The current byproduct value is the highest since January 2015. And the August steer hide values were up 115% year over year. And, of course, those prices are in U.S. dollars. Probably going to hit the leather workers and saddle makers there. At the Kamloops Yards of the B.C. Livestock Co-op, there's a regular sale plus a special calf sale October 12th. And then on October 13th, it's the Angus Influence Calf Sale at the Williams Lake Yards. The regular sale is October 14th. Regular cattle sale in Vanderhoof, October 15th. And take note now that all the regular sales in Kamloops and Williams Lake will be starting at 9 a.m. And you can get all the information, see the sale, streaming live at bclivestock.bc.ca. Meanwhile, at the Innisfail Auction Market, regular cattle sales, of course, continuing every Wednesday, and there will not be a pre-sort sale on Monday, October 11th, but they start again October 18th. Calves are delivered and sorted on Sundays. To consign your calves, just give them a call at 1-800-710-3166. And take note that the scheduled horse sales for the next while have been postponed for now. Okay, now the final item, and got a call from a neighbor up the road the other day, and they were wondering if I knew who owned the white cows that were up on the road near their place. And I asked if he could see the brand, and he said, oh yeah, it looks like an RX on the left shoulder. And I said, well, I'm not sure, but I know how you can find out. Just phone your pharmacist. He says, really? Why? I said, because RX is a prescription brand. And that's the Rangeland News. Coming up on the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, a listener has a pretty nice Arab quarter horse mare with one problem. If she gets a little stirred up, even sometimes from just getting into a good gallop, she seems to be wired and amped up for the rest of the day. But there are a few things that might help. You'll hear them when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. The Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File is coming right up, and we'll look at some things that might help a somewhat hyper mare. First, though, we are still tentatively scheduling our farewell Spirit of the West cruise to begin June the 15th, 2022, with a 7-day trip up the Inside Passage to Alaska and back to Vancouver. Now, these days, of course, we don't know what's over the next hill, and I don't think anybody else does either. But our longtime cruise directors, Jim and Karen, have all the information on how you can tentatively book your spot for this potential great trip. Their number is 1-800-530-0131. And there's a lot of information on our cruise pages at our website, hugh-mcclennan.com.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
It's true, folks are always telling me how much they love shopping at Irvine Tack and Western Wear, but many of them live way over yonder and far away, or they're still uneasy about heading too far from home. I tell them, no problem. Go to urbans.ca and shop online. It's all there. The biggest names in Western wear, oodles of saddles, and all that unique Western home decor. So giddy up and get online at urbans.ca today. Urban Tack and Western Wear,
Canada's largest Western store.
Got talking about horses with some friends the other day, and one of them had a problem that is pretty common. He has an Arab quarter horse cross mare, about 8 years old, pretty good horse, except she's a little hot-blooded, and he has real problems working cattle with her. Whenever she gets going faster than a fast trot, it seems to really get her engine revved up, and she'll be hyper and prancing and dancing and snorting with her head up in the air for the rest of the day. Well, I'll tell you what works pretty well, and I learned this, like so many other good things, from Jonathan Field. Every chance you get, work your horse on a responsibility circle. In the pasture, in the arena, anywhere there's enough room to ride in a circle, somewhere around 60 to 100 feet in diameter. and it works best at a trot to start with. Have a center point in the circle. It can be a bush, a cone, or even a piece of horse poop. Ride the circle at a trot for several revolutions with the objective of being able to drop your rein or hand or hands on your horse's neck and let him continue to stay on the path right on the circle. Here's how. As soon as you feel him drift off course, ride across the center. As soon as you're at the opposite point of the circle, head back on the path and release him. And if you do this right, it won't take long before he will make it his responsibility to stay on the circle without you having to hold him there. And he'll eventually soften and find relaxation when he's trotting that circle. And you'll know he's letting down when you hear him blow air out through his nose. That's all that tension just being released. Eventually, he'll associate relaxation with that circle no matter where he is. And when you find him getting revved up on the trail or in the arena, you can put him back on that circle for a little while and you'll just feel that tension melt away. And for Irvin Saddles and Western Wear, that's the horse training file. Boy, old Cody has been really putting the hours in this fall, and as she's 19 years old, she gets that daily feeding of Hoffman's horse ration. And you know, just the other day I was remarking to Matt when he was putting a new set of shoes on her that was the first day she'd had off in the last 14 or so, and she just seems to be getting stronger and stronger, and we attribute a lot of that to that daily feeding of Hoffman's horse ration. Find out what's in it at hoffmanshorseproducts.com. You'll hear a little more from the gang ranch manager, Larry Ramstead, in a few minutes. You know, the DeLue Ranch is about an hour's drive from our place. Beautiful spot. And when Cody's in the trailer and we're headed over there either early in the morning or heading back home after a great day of gathering and moving steers with a fine crew in that beautiful rolling postcard picture country, I've always got music playing in the truck. And it's always something like this great song, written and sung by my Texas friend R.J. Vandegrift.
Cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free,
the life for me.
Cowboy free.
The sun's coming up, it's gonna be a good day for a man to be outside. Gonna catch me a pony and saddle him up and take myself a ride, take myself a ride. Not a worry in the world, not a care on my mind, soft breeze on my face. Ain't gonna hurry, gonna take my time, boys, riding at an easy pace,
riding at an easy pace.
'Cause there ain't no place I'd rather be than setting this saddle between my knees. Cowboy's life is the life for me, living cowboy free. I'm living cowboy free.
Cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free,
the life for me.
Cowboy free.
When the sun gets hot, I find the shade beneath an old oak tree. Watch cattle graze and the doggies play, as far as the eye can see, as far as the eye can see. There's a buck in the meadow and a doe on the hill, the cattle are looking fine. The old big river running cool and clear as I go loping by,
as I go loping by.
And there ain't no place I'd rather be than sitting this saddle between my knees. A cowboy's life is the life for me, living cowboy free. I'm living cowboy free.
Cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free,
the life for me.
Cowboy free.
There's a great bald eagle in the sky up above, a sailing on the wind. I'll tip my hat as he passes me by and say good morning, friend. Say good morning, friend. When the sun goes down and the moon comes out, the stars begin to shine.
As a coyote howl and a whippoorwill sings, I'll dream by an old campfire.
Dream by an old campfire.
Cause there ain't no place I'd rather be than sitting this saddle between my knees. A cowboy's life is the life for me. Living cowboy free, I'm living cowboy free.
The sun's coming up, it's gonna be a good day for a man to be outside. Gonna catch my pony and saddle him up and take myself a ride.
Take myself a ride.
Cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free, cowboy free.
The life for me,
cowboy free, I'll always be
cowboy free.
The way the Canada Revenue Agency deals with ranchers and farmers has changed a lot in the last few years, and the financial decisions we make today can have a long-lasting impact on our bottom line far into the future. It really helps to have a trusted professional who really understands your situation to guide you with all your accounting requirements and your tax preparation. Having an accountant who knows the difference between a Hereford and a heifer, what a slick and backgrounding are, and that Alfalfa and Timothy are not just names from a storybook really helps. Kathy McMillan of PMT Chartered Professional Accountants understands the intricacies of specialized programs like Agri Stability and Agri Invest. She understands the demands on your time and can help you spend more time doing your job and less time dealing with endless piles of paperwork. See PMTaccountants.com or call toll-free 877-383-8081. Over the years, Billy and I have had to deal with what we thought was our share of calving challenges, and there were times when we said to each other, wow, here's something we've never seen before. But you know, there are a lot of men and women working on the big outfits of the West, and they see more in one season than some of us have seen in 20 years. And Larry Ramstead talked a little about that.
You know, I've talked to folks that say, well, yeah, I calved out 20 heifers a couple of years ago, and I know all about calving heifers. Then I've talked to guys like Stan and Puck and see these other guys that literally, and you, they calved out thousands and thousands of heifers. And I guess over that spell of time, you've seen just about every calving complication the guy's going to run into.
Yeah, and back to what I was saying earlier there, I think that, you know, these young fellows are better than they've ever been. We've got, you know, two or three on the crew that can do a C-section or whatever is required, and you know, they read well, and they can, you know, the new vaccines are all up to date on all that kind of stuff. So, yeah. Again, back to the calving, if you calve 600 or as in Douglas Lake, 1,200 or 1,400 heifers a year, you've probably seen everything in 1 year, that, or at least as much in 1 year as most ranchers will see in a lifetime.
That's right. Well, you've got a good shot at the championship of the Ranch Rodeo tonight, Larry, as we speak. We don't know what the final results are going to be, but we got three teams in the finals, and I want to thank you for sitting down and doing this. Hope it wasn't too painful for you, and wish you guys every success tonight. We're going to be pulling for you and Douglas Lake and Quilshanna, and any of the three of you guys make it, that's good with us.
That'll be great. No, it's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Larry. Give us a call when you're coming through Kamloops sometime.
Thank you.
Well, coming up, Don Edwards brings back a long-lost Jimmy Rogers song in our Western Classic Song segment, then a poem with a lot of feeling beautifully recited by Montana cowboy Randy Reeman, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. The piece you'll hear in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight is one about the season winding down, the crew making plans for the winter, and Randy Reeman has it right after this week's classic Song of the West, and it goes way back to the 1930s and was written by the legendary Jimmy Rogers, the singing brakeman. A lot of his were railroad songs, but he did write his share of cowboy songs too, like this one, brought back by Don Edwards, Land of My Boyhood Dream.
Alone
spaces and a home that is dear to me. It's years since I left the prairie where the coyotes roam at night and howl while the stars they are blinking and the moon shines clear and bright.
Spotlight this week, written and recited by Randy Reeman, and we'll just let Randy introduce it.
I've been extremely fortunate in my life. I've been able to ride in some of the most beautiful landscapes in North America with some of the best cowboys in the business. I consider it a privilege and a blessing to have made my living as a working cowboy. About 10 years ago, I rode for the West Fork Stock Association, and that's about 100 sections of land outside the borders of Yellowstone National Park. It's got the West Fork of the Madison River running right through it, and I shared my responsibilities there with a man named Todd Burley. We'd go into that camp in the spring, and we'd come out in the fall. It was an extremely beautiful place, and it was a hard place to leave. I wrote this poem about that place and about Todd. The poem's entitled, Leaving Camp. Spring's a distant memory now. The green grass turned to brown. The scattered leaves of aspen trees blow golden across the ground. The larkspur and the lupine are faded out and gone. An ice has formed along the banks down at the beaver ponds. An early autumn snowfall has whitewashed distant peaks, and the cattle sensing winter leave the high ground in retreat. This snow will melt neath autumn's sun before it comes to stay, but the warning's made and heeded. We know winter's on its way. The circling of the sandhill cranes reminds us that it's time to be moving off a summer range and leaving camp behind. The season's nearly finished. Like the cranes, the time flies by. We'll soon be rolling up our beds and shaking hands goodbye. So we linger on the ridges in the sunset's parting rays, and we walk and talk instead of trot, and try to stretch the days. These autumn days we cherish while our youth is on display. are the ones we know we'll long for when we're burdened down with age. It's more than nature's beauty that I hate to leave behind. It's the friend who, mile after mile, has ridden by my side from the cold gray light of morning till the long day's twilight end. A good and faithful partner and a trusted lifelong friend. With a handshake and a few brief words, we'll wish each other well. Then both go our separate ways to face the winter's chill. But leaving camp ain't easy when it's shared with such a friend. The kind you've been to me, Todd. Hope we share camp soon again. Like on Dios, amigo.
Well, thanks again for taking time to ride along, and I sure hope you can be right back here next week at the same time when I'll visit with a very interesting couple from just across the river. As always, thanks to our great support crew, Mark and Kathy McMillan, and if you enjoy this, I know you'll love Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine. You can subscribe online at cowboycountrymagazine.com. And I usually have the phone camera along on a lot of our fall roundup rides, and you can see some of them on our YouTube channel, and that's where you can watch and hear this program and most of our shows from the last several years. And you can get it as a podcast, too. The links are on our website, hugh-mclennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.